Penguin Random House Audio presents Like She Owns the Place. Give yourself the gift of confidence and ignite your inner magic. This is the author, Cara Alwill. This one's for you, Mom. You had the power all along, my dear. The Wizard of Oz. Introduction. I am a woman who has spent her entire life obsessively trying to become comfortable in her own skin. I am a woman who has desperately sought ways to embrace every part of herself and to dispel the completely unattainable ideas that society has brainwashed us into believing. That women must be flawless, simultaneously feminine and strong, but not too strong. Successful, but not to the point where that success threatens a man. Beautiful, but not to the point where our beauty intimidates other women. Confident, as long as we don't say it out loud. And skinny. Don't forget skinny. The world has tried to zip me inside a constricting dress. And after spending years trying to breathe inside it, I'm done. I feel ready. Ready for a new way to do life. Ready to challenge the antiquated ideas and pressure from the media that have smothered women for decades. Ready to throw guilt out the window. Ready to raise my middle finger to diet culture, magazine covers, and self-help books that tell us we're sick and broken. Ready to show women that we are enough, right now, exactly as we are. I'm inviting you to boldly redefine confidence with me. I am inviting you to question everything you were programmed to believe. Because here's one thing I have finally learned. It's not about the thinnest woman in the room with no wrinkles and toned abs and a $4,000 handbag. It's about the woman in the room who knows in her heart that she's a motherfucking boss. It's about the woman in the room who can give herself everything she wants, who makes others feel valued, and who turns that damn room upside down simply by walking into it. And she's not doing it for anyone's pleasure but her own. She isn't turning heads because she's the most liked or the most intimidating. She's turning heads because her energy is undeniable. The most confident women are the ones who feel it, and we can't help but see it and want to soak in every single part of it because it's just that real. It's time we all realize we can all be that woman. It's time we realize that becoming her is as simple as deciding. Can you imagine what your life would be like if you were no longer available for the struggle? If you retired the idea of perfection and decided to fully and wholeheartedly be yourself? And even better, love yourself? Imagine you stopped putting your happiness in the hands of others. Imagine you stopped waiting for validation from external forces. Imagine you became intimate with failure, cellulite, success, wrinkles, imperfection, fuck-ups, and vulnerability. Can you imagine what life would be like if you just decided to feel good now? This is new territory for me, if I'm honest, but it's fabulous territory. It's liberating territory. It's empowering territory. And it's work. Maintaining the confidence I've found is a daily practice. It requires patience, dedication, forgiveness, and an incredible amount of self-compassion. It requires taking a good, hard look at my life and knowing when to let things go. It requires asking myself honestly what I need. You've probably read that confidence is a choice, and while that's true, it's more accurate to say that confidence is a series of repeated choices to accept yourself. What does it mean to accept yourself? I used to think accepting myself was a form of giving up. Somewhere along the way, I convinced myself that if I accepted my body, it meant giving up on being healthy. I thought if I accepted my personal best rather than frantically striving for perfection, I would no longer produce quality work. I thought if I owned my flaws, I would somehow let myself go. I didn't understand that I could truly love and embrace myself and be confident while simultaneously building a better version of myself. Eventually, through years of hard work, I began to reprogram my mind. I came to understand that the biggest act of self-love was bettering myself. Being healthy, embracing my failures, and feeling beautiful, but for an entirely new set of reasons. I came to understand that we can and should change, but it must all begin with love. I came to understand that an evolving mind is a healthy mind, and we should evolve as a natural part of our growth as women, not because society tells us to or because we're trying to keep up with others. I've spent most of my life trying to be more beautiful, skinnier, and so on. When I think back on how much time I've spent trying to fix myself, it makes me so sad. The time I've wasted starving myself into a pair of jeans or beating myself up over a mistake is time I could have spent laughing, smiling, and loving myself. The time I've spent waiting for the perfect moment is time I could have spent experiencing life. The time I've spent waiting for the right words is time I could have spent wearing my heart on my sleeve and, as a result, feeling all the raw, messy, and beautiful feelings that come with that. It took me a long time to overcome all the bullshit. It took me a long time to develop an unshakable sense of inner peace and become intimate with my intuition. It took me a long time to achieve real, sustainable confidence. My passion for my own personal development led me to become a certified master life coach so that I could help others too. I saw so many women around me struggling with their self-esteem, constantly questioning their own choices, and living for everyone but themselves. I knew I could apply my own experiences and success on my journey to building my confidence, coupled with the training and skills I received from my coaching education, to help women heal. It is now not just my passion, but my life's work. Through my career as a life coach, I have traveled the world, hosted events, written 6 personal development books prior to this one, and helped thousands of women become empowered and live their best lives. My goal with this book is to share with you how I have arrived here and how I've helped my clients arrive here, and hopefully save you years of pain, shame, and uncertainty on your adventure to find your own self-worth. Because girl, I know how rocky this road can be. I'm going to show you how to block out all the noise around you and how to free yourself from the opinions and judgments of others. I'm going to teach you how to trust your gut, reclaim your life, and rock what you've got. I'm going to help you own the place. Chapter 1, Who Do You Think You Are? It's a chilly spring afternoon, and I'm sitting in the chair at my salon getting my roots done. I think I want pink hair, I blurt out to my stylist, Taryn. It's taken me 6 months to say this out loud. She half ignores me, brushing off my monumentally brave admission with a giggle. I've hinted at liking pink hair to her before, but never made a declaration as direct as this. As she continues to apply bleach to my head, I explain that I'm serious. No, really, I'm ready for it, I tell her, clutching my iPhone, which is filled to near capacity with photos of pink-haired strangers and quotes about confidence and living in your truth that I've been secretly collecting for months. My hands are sweating, causing the phone to slip from my fingers and fogging the screen. I've wanted pink hair for as long as I can remember, but I was always too fearful to do it. I was terrified of what others would think. In high school in the 1990s, while kids dyed their hair funky colors, I barely found the nerve to use sun-in to give myself a blonde streak. I've always felt connected to the weird kids or the outsiders, the ones who took chances and dared to live life on their own terms, the ones who risked mockery for the sake of their own self-expression. I admired their audacity, but I struggled with expressing that part of myself, at least from a physical standpoint. I was an insecure teen who struggled with her weight, so the idea of drawing more attention to myself with wild hair seemed completely out of the question. I hated being the chubby girl. And being the chubby girl with weird hair, I just couldn't handle it. Seriously? Want to do it now? Taryn asks, like a teenager who's just scored a jar of manic panic and can't wait to use me as her guinea pig in her parents' basement. Should we? Pull up some pictures of what you want. I'll go mix some color and be right back. The next thing I know, Taryn is rolling a cart toward me, with a bowl of cotton candy pink dye and a paintbrush. I'm frantically loading my Pinkspiration photo album on my phone to present to her. I'm excited and scared shitless. A few gut-wrenching, wine-filled hours later, I emerge from the salon with a few baby pink peekaboo highlights toward the end of my platinum blonde hair. We decided to ease into things. I meet my cousin for brunch and feel a strange combination of pride and fear.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.